was all just a dream. It seemed so real, so true.
What seemed real? Hannah asked, waking up on cue.
The devil, the fiddle, and you as a princess, all of it.
So I'm not a princess? I'm not fit?
Please still tell me you'll stick by my side. You won't be lost through thick and thin, no matter the cost. But Hannah has left the room, and our story must resume.
Show.
Big premiere tonight, you know.
Yeah, it's great, but I'm so sick of this life. I want to go home to Tulsa, Joe, and someday be your wife.
I know, babe. Me too. Just trust me. See this through. Joe hesitates, leaving the room, then crosses the threshold. Walking anywhere near the blackjack tables always makes him grow cold. Unavoidably, he passes near the table of Sam Hill, a dealer, an agent, the devil.
Hi, Joe. Always good to see you. But never as nice as to see Hannah, too. She's a good one, you know. Quite a catch. Some rifts between us I'd like to patch.
Hannah's still asleep. She's my girl now, you know. We all must choose. You reap what you sow.
Ever so slightly, Sam winces, not taking Joe's words too lightly. Joe continues, facing his foe.
We can all only star in one show. You must follow your path, your dream. No one else's life to live, it would seem.
One thing for sure, from my view, you sure do like showgirls, don't you?
wouldn't be seen with anything less. And you? Come on now, confess.
Why do you contribute to such sin? You sit here all day taking people's money in. You're a snake. And how you treat and own your girls, all at what stake? Your heart is a sieve. Have you ever really lived?
Oh, yes, I've lived. To have my life, what you wouldn't give. As for the girls, I'm just doing my civic duty. Care to place a bet? Play a couple of hands, maybe three? Right. You quit. What was the reason?
Civic duty and a certain agreement.
Of course. The new show, what's the name again?
Starts tonight. Never Odd or Even.
Interesting name for a Vegas show. Tough to bet on that, though. Reminds me of a riddle, something about which I used to fiddle. Never odd or even. I prefer pie. On desserts, I stress, no, I prefer pie. Never odd or even.
What is that nonsense you believe in?
Just something to consider, in case you lost something precious to a higher bidder.
Whatever. I gotta go. Can't wait to get out of this place, this hellhole.
You kidding? I love this place. Someday I will own it.
A smile washed across his face. Joe leaves the table to warm up for the show. Hannah is already stretching, having arrived a few minutes ago. Sam pops his head into the room. Joe and Hannah know that wherever Sam is, evil must loom.
Well, hello, Hannah, my friend.
He winks again, meant to offend.
Don't forget our little deal. Too soon to pack your bags quite yet, I feel.
Hannah is confused. Joe upset, not amused.
Joe! What was that all about?
Nothing. It's all fine. In a week, we are gone, no doubt.
Joe, what isn't fine?
Trust me, Hannah. It's all part of the design.
Thank you.
hands Joe a deck of cards, who recoils at the sight.
All will be fine if you play your cards right.
Watching Sam limp away, an idea strikes Joe for another day. It is the day of the opening, and on the street is Sam, advertising for a show to compete.
Come see Wicked One, the best show in town.
Why does he do this? I'm on his roster.
He's crazy. He's a monster. Damn it, I'm mad. We're being maligned. I'm gonna go give that little boob a piece of my mind. Joe walks over to Sam in a hurry, each step increasing his fury.
That's it, okay? You win. I'll play you for the girl. Just say when. If I win, all contracts scratched, and Hannah and I leave for Tulsa.
Ah, gonna come back to the table, eh? Deal. 1 week from today, we play.
Joe returns to Hannah, not as quickly, deep in thought, looking somewhat sickly.
I can't believe it's foul play. This isn't fair. What did you say?
Just letting him know that I'm not your average Joe. I'm someone to be dealt with, you know? The time has arrived. Everything in place. Everyone having prepared at furious pace. Cast and crew rehearsed and steady. The audience now in their seats and ready. The show has commenced, about 20 minutes in. Hannah's big numbers next to be danced.
Thank you.
Success. Hannah a star, nothing but good press. Joe begins to unravel his plan, slowly, carefully, to be sure that Hannah understands. 1 week from tonight, at the table with Sam, I'll play him in cards, allowing him the slam. I will lose, again and again, as he grows ever more confident with each win. That night at the show, you will injure your foot. That final jump in the last dance, come down hard, make sure it hurts. You'll be done, off the show. Sam won't watch you, he'll pretend you're someone he doesn't even know.
But Sam is my boss, he owns me, he won't want the loss.
Trust me, Sam won't want you for keeps, he only dates working showgirls. He's one of the world's biggest creeps. Make the injury a good one. Make it for real. It needs to look like the leg is shattered from knee to heel. It is 1 week later. Joe and Sam play cards. Sam's confidence increasingly greater. It is crucial that Joe succeed in losing, of course, fueling Sam's greed.
Victory is surely my fate.
Better.
Now I won! Now I won!
I will leave. I have lost. You get the girl. For me, this is my cost. Joe and Hannah are nervous. Hannah on stage. Joe in the pit below. In his seat. So far, Hannah's performance can't be beat. The pressure is much too great. Joe begins to hesitate. Stage. Sam runs to find them afterward, enraged. But Joe finds Sam first, Joe acting in despair, while Hannah sits nearby, crutches against a chair. Congratulations, Sam. Hannah is all yours. I'll pack my bag. We've settled all scores.
Are you kidding? She can't dance anymore. She's no good. Take her. Get out the door. Quick. Take her back to that awful place that's, I don't know what, a Tulsa, nightlife, gin, a slut.
He motions toward Hannah on the final word. Hannah is obviously offended at what she overheard, but Joe grabs her and they run out of the hall. Hannah leaves her crutches behind, no sign of a limp at all. Sam, realizing he's been tricked by something even he couldn't predict, begins to devise a scheme, realizing things aren't always as easy as they seem. Part 2. Tulsa, Oklahoma. It's the holidays. Time has passed. Things have progressed a ways. There is a small storefront decorated in holiday decor. The store has a sign, Lucy's Fur. Joe and Hannah are walking downtown. Hannah humming loudly, happy at the new life they found. Sits in the glass pane. Joe looks at it and begins to miss life in the fast lane. Hannah, there's not enough going on here. We're totally off the radar, it's clear. I feel like life is passing us by, like a race car on the fly. It's just so boring. Never ordered even, always the same easy living. I want to have fun. No worries. Life is a gamble, right? A series of crazy stories. Let's be bold. No one knows what the future holds. Sam is now disguised as a woman peddler, dismissed at first by the couple as a crazy heckler. He tries to sell Hannah some furs. She dismisses them. They show no allure. But then Sam offers something of note.
With this fur purchase, 2 free tickets to Vegas,
was the quote. This is too much for Joe. He talks Hannah into the fur. Hannah takes the tickets and puts them in her purse. I need some coffee. I'll get you a cup too. Sam and Hannah carry the transaction through. Joe returns, coffee in hand. Here you are, honey, your favorite brand. Hannah, looking at the coffee, is obviously frustrated. Did you forget and get caffeinated? Joe, I can tell. Drinking this stuff is pure hell. You know the saying, to avoid trouble, lived on decaf, faced no devil. An argument ensues. And Sam leaves, smug with success, and content to deceive. Joe also departs to fix his mistake. Hannah is alone and begins to think, maybe it is time to try once again. I believe dancing still lies within. Is again approached by Sam, this time disguised as a talent agent, up to another sham.
Madam, I'm Adam, and I have an offer. I need a new showgirl in Vegas. Might be good for the coffers. The show is called Name No One Man, and it's clear where you'd stand. You'd be the perfect lead for sure, and your salary would be...
He whispers in her ear. Hannah is, of course, flattered, suddenly intrigued.
Seriously? Can you level with me? Is this real or rigged?
Yes, it's true. But rehearsals start day after next. We must go now. No time to reflect.
Off we go, then. We can catch the next flight. I happen to have 2 tickets. We'll be there tonight.
Sam walks ahead, and Hannah quickly jots a note. Joe, hold on to this fur, she wrote.
I'm following the dream, just as you said. This isn't the life to be led.
Joe returns soon thereafter, finds everything, and reads.
Angrily, he throws down coffee and fur,
and not knowing how to proceed.
Thank you.
scene shifts back to the strip. Sam, in his element, having given Joe the slip. Time has passed. Sam and Hannah are a couple, though somewhat miscast. To Vegas to try to win Hannah back. And no one speaks to him. He's been given the sack. Having quit the show, he's off the list. For musicians, he doesn't even exist. Basking in fame for which he is the source. Joe watches them from afar, his heart still broken, now beginning to scar. I have to have her back. I need a plan. She has to know I'm her man. It's mid-afternoon. In a Vegas casino, Joe spots Sam, not a moment too soon. Now disguised as a top casino owner, Joe motions over to Sam, inviting him over. Care for a quick game?
Sure. What's the A?
Stakes are high, I can't deny. Let's play, or are you too shy?
I'm intrigued, for sure. Let's see where this goes. I feel secure.
They play. Joe loses, and again loses some more. He offers Sam a drink, and then another four.
I should probably stop drinking before going adrift.
Nonsense! No, tie it on. You haven't lived. Joe pours Sam another drink. The bets still rise. Finally, he offers, looking right into Sam's eyes. I tell you what, I'm out of dough, but should I lose again? I can offer the casino. They play again. Sam, eager for the keys. It's only a matter of time, as he wins with ease. Here you go, the keys to my office. The door's over there, no need to be cautious. Sam runs to the door, barely controlled. He struggles at the lock. The keys, of course, being of the wrong stock. He fails to notice, while furious at the task, the police coming. No questions to ask. Taken away under police protection, he passes Joe and Hannah, glancing their direction.
You tricked me, Joe. You caught me in your butterfly net. Beat me at my own game. You won the bet. Evil did I dwell, lewd did I live. Alas, no devil lived on. Can you ever forgive?
You were a liar from the beginning. It's all primeval. One can live not on evil. I get it now. I had it all wrong. I prefer pie, never odd or even. Had both backwards all along.
Now turning to Hannah, more conscious of his thoughts. I had it backwards, Hannah. I got lost in spots. Looking for happiness, I kept running all over the place. All along, it was right in front of me, in front of my face. I get it now. I was such a bother. We don't have to be odd or even, one or the other. We can have all the numbers, forever and ever. It's like pie, ending never. It may be irrational, but I prefer pie, and this is why. He takes her arms and continues, wanting to get it all out before the moment is gone. No one knows what the future holds, but you can take hold of your future. Be bold. Sure, life's a gamble, but we keep moving on. For sure, I can tell you, now I won. Joe repeats it again, a little slower this time. He wants his girl to hear three words so sublime. Now I won, he says. Our lives have just begun.
Joe, let's start anew. Tulsa, okay with you?
Okay with me.
They leave the casino immediately. They have their bags in tow. It's dusty, hot outside as they walk down the road.